Okay, so take two, take three, I don't know. I need to apparently slow down and make sure I'm thinking about things as we're doing this. So today, once again, we're gonna go through and talk a little bit about vaccinating and giving shots, in this case in sheep. And so I have a couple of things just to kind of show you before I actually do this, and then we'll kind of roll on here. But first and foremost, anytime you're giving any kind of livestock any sort of medication or manipulating them in any sort of way, you should probably keep track of things. Number one, for your record. Number two, if you happen to sell the animal, you kind of know what's going on. Number three, if it is an animal that will be sold for market products, or if it's an animal that's going to be producing milk products or anything for human consumption, you gotta have real accurate records to make sure you know what's going on and you don't get yourself in trouble. So first and foremost, I have this lovely little spreadsheet right here that's got all of our information on these animals on, and we're going through anything that's getting a shot, it's getting put on here, and then I go enter it in and make sure that I get all of our dates written down. So we also want to check to make sure we're accurate with our animal and giving the right thing. So this sheep right here, 2005, we've got kind of her information on the back of the tag as well. We're double checking just to make sure we're getting the right animal. These are a couple examples of some different vaccines that we can give sheep. I just pulled a few out for us to kind of look at today as I show you how to give a shot. So this one here is Clostridial perfringens type CD&T plus tetanus toxoid. It's an extremely, extremely common vaccine that we give very commonly in sheep. In fact, this is probably one of the most commonly given things that sheep will get. Typically, we give this to the ewe as they're pregnant to help start building up some immunity in the babies and the fetuses. But typically lambs, baby lambs, will get this shortly before they're weaned. And then again, they'll get a booster shot a little while later. Basically, the goal of this is to help prevent overeating and basically bad bugs in their guts. And then, of course, tetanus, which most people, most animals, end up getting a tetanus shot too. So hopefully everybody kind of understands that a little bit. So that's sort of what we're going to be giving here in just a second. I'm going to set this down. He's eating my gloves. Not nice. Here's a couple other examples of some vaccines that we can give. So this one's caseback. So we give it basically to help prevent some nasty stuff from happening. Basically another thing that it could be called would be cheesy gland. They get abscesses that build up. Immune system's not real great. And it can cause a lot of issues in some cases. So we can use this as a preventative for some things. And then this would be what we call Campylobacter fetus jejuni bacterium, and basically what this is to help prevent abortions in sheep, and so this can be a whole bunch of different things that can kind of pester them and cause that to happen. Typically we would give this shortly before breeding season, or in some cases people will wait until they're actually bred. It kind of depends on your operation a little bit. Most people give this right before. Some people do not give this at all. If you've never had a problem with abortions or anything like that, probably don't need to worry about it. By the way, animals abort spontaneously for lots of different reasons. So if you have a lot of animals, you're probably going to be treating for something at some point. Some people will also, instead of giving injections, some people will feed in the form of some kind of crumble that they'll add to their feed mixture, or powder that they'll add to their feed mixture. That could be something to use as well. So in the case of sheep, you could feed CTC. In some small quantities as well. Most of these products are directed by your veterinarian, and so you would ask them for assistance. I kind of have a program that I follow a little bit. So anytime we're going to be giving any kind of medication, first and foremost, we need to read the label to understand where to give it, how much to give, and what we're supposed to be doing with this stuff. So we've gone through, we've read the label, we've kind of made sure this is mixed up a little bit. There's no stuff kind of sitting on the bottom. Some things will require to be shaken. Some things don't shake. You just kind of stir a little bit. Some you won't. Just kind of depends on what you're giving. In this case, we're giving this subcutaneous or under the skin. And we're going to be giving 2 cc's of this is what we're going to be doing. So this is what our bottle looks like. And so when we go to give our shot, this is what it would look like. Now, I actually already filled the syringe up, so I'm going to fill up another syringe here for you to look. But this is the one we're going to be giving to this particular sheep. This was a fresh syringe, fresh needle. Make sure everything is all clean and ready to go. I'll show you another one and how we pull it up here in just a second. for the next sheep, but in this case, we're gonna give this to her first, so we're kind of keeping track of stuff. So, as you can see, we've got 2 cc's pulled up into our syringe. This is a 12 cc syringe. We've got a 20 gauge by 1 inch needle, so 20 would be the thickness of it, 1 inch would be the length of this needle. We're gonna set this back down. Since we're giving this subcutaneous, we're giving it under the skin, so that means in the case of our sheep, we're gonna give it in the armpit. And so, in sheep, anytime we give things in the armpit, I like to go in the left armpit, because that would be the non-show side of the animal. So in the case we were showing an animal, which she's not gonna get shown, but in the case we were going to be showing her, we wanted to put it on the non-show side in case there's any reaction or it lumps up at all. It just looks a little bit nicer. So armpit would be located right here. So we're just basically going under this flap of skin. Hopefully you can kind of see that there. So I'm gonna stick my needle in kind of at an angle. It's right underneath the skin. I'm gonna inject quickly and pull it out so we don't run our camera person over. Whoop. And now we gotta get that clean. So you can see we injected all the medication in. I'm gonna put the cap on the needle, and we're gonna go dispose of the syringe here in just a minute. But before we do that, we're gonna write down what we gave her, make sure we get that taken care of. So she's on our list right here. So we're gonna mark her off. We're gonna check this off. We're gonna date it, make sure that we know she's taken care of. Now, another example. So we'll draw up some of the case back for another shot here, for another sheep. So we've got our stuff in here. Again, this one happens to be 2 cc's. Here we've got our fresh syringe and needle. So I keep those ready to go in the box. So when we're getting a whole bunch of shots, it's quick and easy. So you can see this syringe is a little different. This is a 3 ml or 3 cc syringe. This needle is also a little bit different. This is an 18, this is a 20 gauge needle as well, just kidding. And this is a 1 inch. We just have a different color cap because it's a different brand. So, kind of stir this up a little bit. I'm gonna hold my bottle upside down. I'm going to put my needle in. I'm going to draw back 2 cc's. Make sure I don't have any air bubbles. Hold tight so that it doesn't move at all. And then I'm gonna pull back out. I'm gonna put my cap back on right away. And then I've got this ready for the next one. So that's a little bit about vaccinating, giving shots, and making sure we're keeping track of our information.